from the meeting, it was a few minutes past one, he comes to his desk. He had a snack briefly and walked over to the, I think he's the managing editor, David Mukoli's desk, for a chat, and left his mobile phone on the desk. So it kept ringing, ringing. So when he came back, I think he tried to return the call. I don't know what they talked on phone. All he said was he was going for lunch at Lugogo. And he was all excited, even asked me whether he could bring me a snack when he's coming back. And then the next thing I know is people are asking me what Charles Etukuri has done. They said they saw people manhandling him downstairs.
We don't have much information, but Charles was picked just right out of the office. It was around 2 p.m. and he just carried a bowl of fruit because I think he'd skipped his lunch to do a story. So as he got into, as he got near his car, he was surrounded by four men. They had army green t-shirts on, but we don't know who they are. And they came near him and surrounded him. There was another person in the car. It was a white double cabin pickup. And they forced him into the car and drove away. We don't know why. We have our suspicions because over the weekend he wrote the story of the investor who was killed in a hotel in Kampala. And the people implicated in that were ISO operatives. We don't know their identity, but that's what we discovered in investigating the story. And we suspect it's related to that because earlier on in the day he mentioned that he had got information that people were not happy about his story. And earlier in the day he had actually been advised to report to police. We have reported to police. The case has already been filed by our legal department. Our legal department is on the alert and they are looking out. We've also alerted a few people to look out for where Charles could be. But I think the biggest security we have as the media is the audiences who we serve, the people we serve, the people we speak out for, the people whose pains we lay bare should be the ones to protect us. They should realize that we do a big job for them, and they should make sure that we are safe as we work.